Well, some of the testimony today was tedious. Some of it was very emotional, resulting in tears and grief.
Officer Blake Snyder's widow, his mom, and family members remained in the courtroom as the medical examiner testified about Snyder's autopsy and showed pictures of the procedure. Family members hugged each other and cried. One bullet hit Snyder in the chin, broke his jaw, traveled downward, putting a hole in a main artery that carries blood to the brain. There was no way he could survive. Former police chief Tim Fitch was at the trial to show support for Blake's family and fellow officers.
I think it's important that they know that they're not out there alone.
A firearms examiner from the St. Louis County Crime Lab testified how a bullet from Trenton Forster's 9mm gun was used to kill Blake Snyder. A DNA expert told jurors that Forster's DNA was found on the murder weapon. A digital forensic examiner said she downloaded data from Forster's cell phone. 8,000 pages of searches and messages were discovered. Forster made more than 130 searches concerning guns. There were statements about the defendant's hate for police and how he wanted to kill them. He talked about his obsession with drugs. There were phone messages from family members warning Forster to keep away from their homes or they'd call police and have him arrested. Gun store owners testified how they refused to sell guns and ammo to Forster because he appeared high on drugs. However, one store did sell him ammo after the store clerk was overruled by a manager. The family ordeal of reliving the murder can only be horrible, but it is also a chance for friends to remember, to salute, and to honor a man who died in the line of duty. Tim Fitch hired Officer Snyder.
I'll never forget the day of graduation because Elizabeth pinned his badge on him, and I remember thinking how young they were and what a cute couple they were.
It was a rough day for some people in that courtroom. Tomorrow morning, we'll hear more from the lead detective in the murder case. In Clayton, Rocky Madden, Fox 2 News.